Currently of this video, I am up $1.7 million in trading profits. If you ask me, Kyle, how do you set a stop loss? I don't know if I could tell you. Like, that's the great part about trading. You don't actually know how to have to, you have to have a mental, I have a mental stop loss for every single trade I take. Don't, you know, mistake in that. I have risk and a stop loss every single time for a trade. But it's not a physical stop loss, it's a mental stop loss.
How's it going, everyone? Matt Monaco here with Kyle Williams.
What's up, guys?
Today, we're just gonna break down like the pros and cons, basically, of listed versus OTC stocks. Lately, like the last 2-3 weeks, I've been trading more listed stocks than OTC. I kind of flip back and forth a lot because I started the year with OTCs. Now I'm just seeing more opportunity on the listed side. So yeah, basically that's my metric for where I'm gonna trade. I'm gonna be honest, it's just like percent movers. The OTC like was super crazy, like January, February-ish of this year. And since then, like a lot of those huge, huge runners, like kind of just the whole market went crazy, has been in a downtrend a little bit. So I've kind of just like avoided it. Yeah, there's been great plays there, but I've kind of just focused on the listed side of things. There's like less overhead resistance, what I see.
Yeah, you know, and I would say for me, I've always been a pretty dominant OTC trader. When the OTCs are hot, it's definitely like 80% OTCs, 20% NASDAQ. But I would say when OTC slows down and NASDAQs kind of speed up, it's like still 50-50 for me. You know, I've never really, would say dominantly have traded NASDAQ over OTC. But yeah, we, you know, like you said, February and January, and even like maybe the first half of March, it was very OTC heavy. To the point where I almost maybe wasn't really touching NASDAQs most of the time. And now we had a few, like 2 or 3 dry week period, the market changed, and we've recently spurred up with some more action, but it is listed. Again, for me, 50-50, but like you just said, Matt, you know, you're more like what, OCGN, MVIS, MMEDF that actually was an OTC that went uplist to NASDAQ to MNMD. So constant evaluation of the market, and right now we're a little hot with listed.
For sure. I think just as we're filming this, BTX is just that low float runner.
That one too.
That we get, because like when OTC slowed down, listed did slow down a little bit, and there just were no sectors running. They were kind of one-off runners. And then BTX came along and just brought basically momentum back to the listed market. Can't remember what it started at, but like sub, like what, $5? Did it start at?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, and it hit after hours on Friday at $75.
Like $70, $80, yeah.
Which
Insane.
Is crazy. Probably will cap up Monday. But just huge squeeze, and when we get a massive runner like that, people are looking for the next runner, usually in the listed market. Same way when an OTC stock runs, they're looking for that next OTC stock. So really, just when you get that one leader, wherever it might be, it kind of spurs, at least for a couple day, couple week period, some momentum in that specific market. Mm-hmm.
So pros and cons, what would you say are, you can do NASDAQ, I'll do OTC, pros, the downside and the upside, or the upside and downside to this last listed NASDAQ, AMX, New York Stock Exchange. Those three, by the way, so to break it down, there's under the listed umbrella, there is the NASDAQ Stock Exchange, the New York Stock Exchange, and then the American Stock Exchange. Those are like the three main ones.
First pro, I'm team listed today.
There you go.
So commission-free trading for most brokers out there.
True.
With listed stocks, which is great if you have a small account. You don't have to worry about those fees with OTCs eating into your profits, you know, because most brokers still, like each rate is still $4.95 for entry and exit for an OTC stock. So $10 round trip. When you're trading with a small account, that $10 can really eat into your profits. And on the listed side, like you don't have to worry about that. That's $10 you can keep in your pocket. It goes towards your P&L still.
Mm-hmm.
Pro one for listed.
Pro one for listed. So I have to come. So we're gonna a little battle here. Pro for OTCs. I would say, and I think you might agree with me on this, they are at least easier to begin with in a way. They are a little bit slower. So it's easier to read. And in an easier read, I mean, it's easier to kind of see price action, see it move. Because NASDAQ, I mean, it could just happen fractions of a second. And you might be, as a beginner, just overwhelmed. Like, what the heck is going on here? Where OTC, you can kind of see, oh, this transaction is happening right before my eyes. It can quite literally be that much slower sometimes. That's why I gravitated to OTCs when I first started. That's why I'm still with OTCs primarily now. Just easy to learn, a little bit smoother. NASDAQ tend to be very choppy, like BTX, for example, is a low float, meaning there's very few limited amount of shares to buy and sell. And then that thing can just move dollars at a time. OTCs rarely will ever do that. Many more lower price OTC, I guess that's another pro, I'm getting ahead of myself, but that's, you know, slower moving, smoother moving, and just easier to learn for OTCs.
Yeah, double dipper. to counter that, yes, percent gains, or I guess you didn't say that, you were kind of alluding to it. They're easier to learn, they're slower, you can think about it more.
Yeah.
But they're harder to fill, right? Which True. Can be very frustrating when you're a new trader. You kind of, it's not that they're hard after a while, just at first they're difficult compared to listed. Listed, you'll just fill instantly, basically.
True.
Because it's electronic mm-hmm. market, ton of market makers, ton of liquidity. So you can pretty much fill at, like, if it's trading, you know, with a one set spread, you'll basically fill instantly. Now on the OTC side, like, you can try to hit the ask or try to hit the bid, depending if you're buying or selling, and not get filled, which
yeah.
can make people angry, especially in, like, emotional situations, whether it's a parabolic spike and they're trying to, like, get in on that spike to ride it up, you might not get filled. Same thing with panic dip buy. Just when that turn comes, if you're not ready, like, yeah, you probably won't get filled.
Yeah, that's the gift and the curse of it. The reason why, that's a great point you made that. The reason why it is slower is because it is difficult to fill. So that's definitely a con for OTC trading. But again, without that con, there wouldn't be that pro. So it's kind of, you just gotta deal with it, you know.
I'm gonna fire back with a pro-con-ish for stock, or for just listed.
Okay.
You get the after hours, right?
You
Which
do.
Does, you obviously, there's like gap up potential, after hour run potential, but it's scary. Like, in OTC world, when market close, it's closed.
It's closed, done.
There's nothing you can do. Like, until 9:30 Eastern the next day, then you can place your
trade. There's no pre-market either. OTC is no after hours, no pre-market. Close, open, that is it. That's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, absolutely. And listed, like, it's actively traded. Like, it's not liquid, per se, but it's actively traded. A lot of listed stocks, too, like, there's usually high offering risks. Like, it's pretty rare to be long OTC overnight and they throw out an offering. But these really crappy listed runners overnight, like, there's a solid offering chance, which can be just very scary, like, if you're not aware of it. Yeah, so it's kind of a wish-wash for listed there.
Yeah, I would say for me, it's almost, I see it almost as a pro or a con depending on your personality. Like, I think that's, again, another reason why I gravitated towards OTC is because one, for pre-market, I live on the West Coast. So the market opens at 6:30 West Coast time. If you want to watch pre-market, I mean, you gotta be up 3:30, 4:30 in the morning. You will never catch me doing that consistently. So I've done it a few times, but not, so listed in general, it's just not gonna be something for me pre-market. Same thing with after hours. By the time the market closes, I'm gonna be honest, I'm done for the day. I'm ready to leave, I'm ready to go spend the rest of my life, do whatever I need to do. So the last thing I wanna do is also watch after hours time. You know, I just don't wanna be in the front of the screens anymore. So that's why I gravitate to OTCs. I love just buying into the close. It closes, it's done. I don't have to think about it anymore until the market opens the very next day. That's just, again, my personal preference. Some people make a lot of gains after hours unlisted. Some people's strategies revolve around that. It's not a very common strategy, but there are traders who do that. I personally know, I know Matt isn't that big on that either, but it's at least an advantage and a pro or a con, depending how you want to look at it.
Sure. Kind of the last pro that just comes to mind for listed, is based around the liquidity. Like, now this bars out like low flow stocks, but if it's like medium, higher flow stock, trading good volume, like, I'm okay with setting a stop loss, like a literal hard stop loss order, because the liquidity is there. And usually when, especially the trades, the stocks we've been seeing where there's 100 million shares traded in a day, the worry of a market maker, like, quote unquote, like screwing you, hunting you over is like, not a real word.
They're computers,
like,
now.
They're computers, you know? Yeah. And there's so many other players, like, they're not trying to target you. So you can put that stop loss in, and, you know, if you have a job, you're in school, you're in classes, like, that's something that can just help you out, putting a stop loss in. So if the trade goes against you and you aren't in front of the computer, you can get out and respect, you know, your risk reward potential. On an OTC stock, though, that is not something I'd want to do.
No.
Stop loss on OTCs are sketchy a little bit. Market makers can kind of hunt you down, and like, your chances of filling, especially if you're setting it like under a support level, like right before a panic, are really low.
Slim. And so again, that is another reason why I gravitated towards OTCs, because I, confession, currently of this video, I am up $1.7 million in trading profits. If you ask me, Kyle, how do you set a stop loss? I don't know if I could tell you. Like, that's the great part about trading. You don't actually know how to have to, you have to have a mental, I have a mental stop loss for every single trade I take. Don't, you know, mistake in that. I have risk and a stop loss every single time for a trade, but it's not a physical stop loss, it's a mental stop loss. So when I'm in a trade, I need to watch it, I wanna be there, because I wanna be able to know if I'm gonna stop out, I'm gonna do it myself. I'm gonna click that button for myself, I don't really want a computer doing it for it. So I've, you know, embarrassingly and admittedly telling you, I don't think I've ever set a stop loss. It's always been mental. So if you don't want to do that, congratulations. I'm an example of someone who has done it without doing it. But again, that's why I like OTCs. I like being there, I like watching it, and I rather try to have control of how I stop out. Again, fills might be slower, it happens, but that's just part of the game if you want to play OTCs.
Well said. Moral of the story, there's no right way, there's no wrong way. OTC, great opportunity, listed, great opportunity. Sometimes they're at the same time, sometimes they shift back and forth, just depending on sectors and just overall momentum. So, you know, you gotta find what works for you, whether that be OTC, like, or listed, both. You know, probably when you're first starting out, like, it's easier to learn one or the other before just trying to digest everything.
Yeah.
Because fundamentally, like, there's different styles of trading, basically.
Of course.
But yeah, that was pro con OTC. Thanks for watching. If you're new, you're not subscribed, make sure you click that button. Yeah, and thanks for watching. Thanks for hopping on with me, man.
Catch you guys next time.